It says expand and simplify this. So we've got two sets of brackets. We want to expand it all out. So here, I want to multiply a with the a and also the positive 1. And this time I want to multiply, this time it's negative a in front, isn't it? So I want to multiply the negative a to the 2 and negative a to the negative 2a. So see how we've got different signs? We've got negative and negative and we've got these involved. So that's why I'm asking you to be extra careful. Okay, so let's do it. A times a is a squared and a times 1 is just a, isn't it? So that's how I expanded the first one. Now here, negative a times 2 is negative 2a, but see here, I changed the sign to a positive because look, negative a times negative 2a, what's negative negative, guys? It's positive, isn't it? So that's why I changed it to a positive, and so many students forget to make this into a positive in their exam. So many people forget this, so every time you get a question like this, be extra, extra careful. Some people just put a negative in front for some reason because they forget. So here, negative negative makes a positive, and then a times 2a is 2a squared. Okay, so that's what I did. Now all we need to do, guys, is gather up our like terms because that's how we simplify. So let's go to the like terms. See how a squared, and we've got a squared here, and we've got an a, and we've got a negative 2a. They're common, aren't they? So we'll gather the common parts like this. Because a plus 2a, sorry, a squared plus 2a squared is 3a squared, and a minus 2a is negative a. Hopefully I don't have to explain too much of the simplifying because we've done that in the previous section. So basically I'm gathering up my coefficients together, right? So that's it. That's the answer to question 8. So again, multiply your a with your b and your c and here. And whenever you have a minus, be extra careful. Minus b times 2a minus b times negative c. And then we do c times a, and then we also do c times negative 3b. Okay, that's all you need to do. So let's do it one at a time. A times b is ab, and a times c is ac. Easy? Now, negative b times 2a. That's negative 2ab. But again, see how I circled that? Negative b times negative c. Negative negative makes a positive. So positive b times c, which is just bc, okay? And then again, c times a is ca or ac. We usually like to keep it in alphabetical order, so put a first, ac. And then c times negative 3b is negative 3bc. This time, it's positive and negative, so we keep a negative, not a positive, okay? And that's it. So now we just gather our like terms to simplify. So see how AB, we've got an AB there, we've got an AB there. Any more ABs? That's it. Now, here we've got an AC, and we've got also got an AC here. And that's it, right? And we've got a BC, and we've also got a BC there, because that's 3BC. So, I gathered up my like terms, okay? So let's go ahead and gather them up by adding or subtracting our coefficients. So, AB and minus 2AB, that's going to be minus AB. Okay, AB minus 2AB is minus AB. Now AC plus AC is 2AC, and BC minus 3BC is minus 2BC. Easy? Very. So